That, it might be said, took the pressure off. Another piece of timing evidence comes from Geraldine Marsh, who lived next door to the Baines with her parents, Wayne and Billy. On the 20th of June, I woke to the sound of the Baines dog barking. I looked at the clock. It was 7 a.m. The dog continued barking until I went back to sleep at about 7:15 a.m. The dog has never barked continuously like this before. The dog had woken me up before, but it only barked about 3 times, never continuously. Casey's racket raises the possibility of yet another scenario, that David left the house for some reason at around 7 a.m., causing the dog, left alone with dead bodies, to bark continuously. David talked about only needing to give Casey the evil eye to stop her barking, so would probably have stopped the noise if he'd been inside the house. This scenario is supported by 2 witnesses, who repeated their accounts in 2019, 25 years after the shooting. The pair, who spoke to me for a story for Stuff and the Sunday Star Times, say 2 detectives visited them and took notes within months of the shooting. Police can find no record of their statements on the Bain file. The witnesses, Fiona Claire McClellan and Greg Shane Wilson, claim they saw a tall paperboy who looked like David Bain at around 7 a.m. at a location near Every Street on the 20th of June. The location was about 4 minutes' walk from the beginning of David's paper run. In June 1994, McClellan and Wilson had been going out for about 6 months. On the day of the murders, McClellan had to be at work to start her shift at the Cadbury chocolate factory at 8 a.m. Wilson had stayed the night with her and accompanied her to the bus stop on the corner of Every Street and Highcliffe Road, not far from McClellan's flat in Pukatai Street.